A woman in the audience asked how she can help her 10-month-old pup to stop barking at people.
Scared of people. What, how she's manifesting the fear is by barking. Okay? So the question would either be, how can I teach my dog not to bark at people? So if we had, say, what breed of dog?
Shih Tzu, Bichon,
little dog, yeah. So if you had like a Rottie or a Pitbull, the question would be, how can I stop my dog barking at people? How can I stop my dog growling at people? Because people get really upset and it gives the dog a bad reputation. When we have a little dog, the question is not, how can we stop the dog barking at people? It's, how can I stop my dog being scared of people? Which is the same question I would ask of the Rottweiler and the Pitbull. No one gets it. The assumption with the Rottie and the Pitbull is he's barking and growling because he's dominant. No, he's just as scared as your little dog. That's why he's barking at people. So I really like the question. Once you've got it out, it's good. All right? How would we do that? The dog is scared of people. What do we need to do? Number one, we're going to take away the dog's food bowl. Here's the deal. If you have a dog that's scared, and the very difficult thing to do is to get it to trust you. It takes time to build confidence. It takes time. We have human analogies that if you get divorced and remarried, it takes years for your child to build confidence around his new dad or his new mom. It takes time to build confidence. We can do it. With your little dog, I can do it. I'm going to get you out of the picture. You cannot socialize a dog if the owner's there. Because the dog just wants the owner and that's it. Like this. And you can't socialize. But if I say, can you leave? Or if you leave, I'm like, hello. I make another friend. You get it? So number one, owner out of there. Now we can start socialization. But it will take time. Unless we use food. When we do food, it goes very quickly. Very, very quickly. As long as the dog is not getting the food for free from his owner in a bowl once a day. Okay, you're going to be responsible for the training because it requires bringing people to your home on a regular basis to hand feed the dog. Or you go on day trips. You weigh out the dog's food in the morning. I don't want this dog getting fat. I don't want treats used in the training. You have a little dog, no treats. I'm a veterinarian, I care for your dog's pancreas. I don't want any fatty foods, I don't want any salt, I don't want any sugar. I want you using kibble as the reward. It only works as a reward if the dog gets it hand-fed only. If he gets it in a bowl for nothing, you now have a spoiled child, you devalued the reward. So no treats, you understand. Don't buy any of those crap treats from stores. It's crap. A good, balanced kibble is now going to be hand-fed by people. You start off 3 days. You do it for 2 days. Then you bring in an unfamiliar woman. Easier first with women. Then you're going to go to nice men, and then girls, and then boys, in that order. The dog is hand-fed. In a day trip, so you weigh up the food in the morning, what everyone knows is if there's food in this container, we can give it to the dog as a classical conditioning treat. A stranger can give it to the dog, so the dog says, I like that stranger. There's no food there, the dog's eaten his calorie allotment for the day. You can take a scoop at any time, put it in the bag, and you can go out and you can sit on a park bench. You've got a cute little dog, and people come along, you say, can you do me a favor and toss my dog a bit of food because he's kind of scared? They're tossing food first. Eventually the dog will take it from their hand. Once they do that, it's come and sit. This is what happens now for the next month, 2 months, 3 months. I want you to evaluate every month, both of you. Do you think is she getting better or not? Because I want you both to say, yep, she's really improving and keep it up. When the two of you can stand in front of your bathroom mirror and hold your hand up and say, I think she's fine now. bring out the food bowl again with our ceremony. And we can all have a big cry and a congratulations, because what you've done is you've made this dog's life just a whole lot happier. Get it? So it sounds funny, but it ain't. Fearfulness is not funny in animals. It's not funny in children. And generally what we do is we just ignore it. That's fine. That's why we start in the house with people she knows. You have two training scenarios. Best possible training scenario, oh, but she's fine at home. And the worst possible training scenario, the child comes running up and pokes her with a stick. You start training here. You have the dog that, worst possible training scenario, chases deer or chases rabbits. Impossible. But here we are in the living room, they can't get the dog to sit there. Always start training in the best possible training scenario. That's why I said you can feed the dog first. It knows you, it trusts you. You teach it the game, he goes next. Dog knows you and trusts you, but probably doesn't like you quite as much as her. That's the way dogs are. They prefer women to men, but it's okay. I have a tip for you. If you close your ears now, put your hands over your ears, I want you to do this. Can you do that while I'm talking? Then the dog will love you more than her.